Hey guys, Brian here with WP Cupid, and today I'm going to show you how to install plugins into WordPress. There's three different ways that we can do this, and the first two are going to be really good for the WordPress beginners, and the third way is going to be for the more advanced users, but all three are generally pretty easy, and I'm going to go through each one. Alright, so as you can see here, we're in the WordPress dashboard. So go over here to the left, we'll see plugins. We're going to click plugins. And up here at the top, you'll see plugins and add new. We're going to go ahead and click add new. All right, and over here, search plugins. This is where you can search for the plugin that you're looking for. I'm going to put in a random one here. All right, so this is the one that I'm looking for. You'll see install now. Go ahead and click that. And once it's done installing, you're gonna see activate here. So you'll go ahead and click activate to activate the plugin. Another thing that you could do, and I'll show you here, is just click plugins again. If you scroll all the way down to the bottom, Yoast SEO, you'll see activate. You can activate it here as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and activate it. All right, that plugin is now activated, and you'll see the different links here at the bottom. Every plugin's different, so you might see different links for different plugins down here. All right, so now moving on to the second way. This way is really easy as well. Disregard this part right here. I'm gonna go ahead and deactivate this plugin so I can show you the second way. I'm gonna delete it. All right, so the second way up here at the top, we're gonna be on the plugins page. You'll see the plugins add new. We'll click add new. And up here we'll see add plugins and upload plugin. You'll want to click upload plugin. And right here at the top you'll see if you have a plugin in a zip format, you may install it by uploading it here. So this is what you want to do, is get the zip format of the plugin that you have and download that to your computer, and you can just upload it right here in this WordPress dashboard. Alright, so we're going to click choose file. And I already have mine saved. We'll click on the zip file and click install now. All right, and right here you'll see unpacking the package, installing the plugin, plugin installed successfully. And right here we can activate the plugin. So I'm gonna click this to activate it. And it'll take you back to the plugins page. Scroll down to the bottom and you'll see all them links down there. And it has been installed successfully. Okay, now we're gonna go over the more advanced way to upload a plugin into WordPress. This will involve using an FTP client and connecting to your WordPress site through your FTP client. For this example, I'm gonna be using FileZilla, an open source FTP client that is free to download. As you'll see, I'm logged into FileZilla here, and up here at the top left, is going to be all the files on the computer. You can see the WordPress SEO. I've already got that folder in place. And over here in the right-hand side, you'll see that I'm under public HTML. And then you'll go to WP content. And under that, you'll see the plugins folder. Double-click that. And this will list out all the plugins that are active on the site currently. You can see I got several already activated. So over here in the bottom left-hand corner where the plugin folder is, go ahead and right-click it and you'll see upload. Go ahead and click upload, and this will upload the plugin to WordPress. You can also drag it over below that index.php file if you'd like to. I'm gonna go ahead and just upload it, and this will actually take some time, so I will come back here shortly. Alright, and so once that plugin is successful in FileZilla and the FTP client, go ahead and go to the WordPress dashboard, click the plugins, and you'll see down here the Yoast SEO plugin that I've been working with. You'll want to go ahead and activate your plugin. When you upload a plugin in an FTP client, it will not activate it. So you'll want to go to the WordPress dashboard in the plugin page and hit activate. Alright guys, thanks for watching. I hope this video was helpful. I provided all the text for you in the description below, and it's going to list it, everything step by step, that we have a guide to go by. Be sure to subscribe to our channel and give this video a thumbs up so we can keep spreading the word.
we go.